Stable Diffusion 3 has sparked heavy discussion online if the creators accidentally used the movie The Thing by John Carpenter as base for Anatomy. In this video, I will explain everything you need to know to get amazing outputs anyway. You just need to combine these two key principles I will teach you. At the time of recording, your best options are Stable Swarm UI or Comf UI. I will use Stable Swarm since it wraps Comf UI. It has an amazing one-click installer. Just download it, put it anywhere you want, and execute it. If you need a more in-depth explanation or want to use Comf UI, I suggest you watch one of these of my videos. In order to follow along properly, you need to download the 4GB version of SD3 Medium. Also, you need to download the three text encoders Clip G, Clip L, and the T5XXL. I will explain what each of these does in a moment. Last but not least, download the three Comf UI workflows that are provided. If you are using Stable Swarm, put your SD3 Medium model in the Models Stable Diffusion folder. The three text encoders go into the clip folder. In Comf UI, however, it's called models and then checkpoints. Text encoders go into the clip folder just like in Stable Swarm. In Stable Swarm, just click up here to open your Comf UI workflow. The first of the two key principles you will need for amazing images like this is understanding the workflow and its settings. Just drag and drop the basic workflow you downloaded in. I know it looks complicated, but if you get the hang of it, it's not more complicated than Automatic or Forge. Here you can find your positive prompt and your negative prompt. Here are your image settings and the used seed. Up here you can find the checkpoint loader. Pick your model. If it says none, then you put it in the wrong folder. Also, you can find the triple clip loader here, which I'll explain later in this video. If we move over here, here are your render settings. We start with 28 steps, a CFG of 4.5, and for sampler, DPM +++ to M. Don't use Keras for schedule type. A lot of people do this. From my testing, the results were mediocre. Also, EMAT suggests to use these settings. The base prompt will yield these images. In SD3, your text prompt can be more descriptive instead of just using keywords. Let's reuse some of this. How about a full body photo of a female character with long flowing hair? Let's delete this and we add standing in a nightclub with a dress in red and black. The background is vibrant and dominated by deep blues and purples. I don't see a dramatic atmosphere, but mysterious can stay. I don't see fantasy or supernatural. Let's replace it with some render settings. Hollywood movie, photorealistic photograph, 35mm Canon EOS D. Okay, let's see where it leads us. The proportions and the anatomy are not perfect, but I've seen much worse. I like this one here very much. Before I show you the second key principle for images like this, just a quick tip here. Currently, images are not saved automatically. Make a double click in a free space and type save. Click save image. And here from the VAE decode node, click and drag it up here. This will now automatically save all your images as soon as they pass the VAE decode node. I will do you one better. Click into the input box and write this. Now when Comf UI saves your file, it looks for a folder that's in the format of the current date. If it does not exist, it gets created. So your images get saved in separate folders sorted by date, which I find really useful. Let's look at this on your hard drive real quick. Up here you can see it created the folder with the current date. And in here are our four images. The second key ingredient for amazing images like this lies in the multimodal diffusion transformer of Stable Diffusion 3. It uses not one, but three pre-trained text encoders, the ones you downloaded earlier, remember? This is where the multi-prompt workflow you downloaded comes into play. Just drag and drop it in. According to the research paper, the T5 H5XXL should be used for the main topic of the image with a detailed description. It's this box down here where I give an elaborate description about Ellie from The Last of Us cosplaying as the Doom guy standing in a hell-like environment. The clip G should be used for secondary elements like context, environment and background. I prompt here a large text in the background saying Last of Us x Doom dominated in deep red, fire as if in hell, etc. The clip L on the other hand should be used for stylistic choices like render style, ensuring high quality images like 4K resolution, ray tracing, etc. Take note that the clip L and clip G have a limit of 77 tokens, so keep your prompts concise. It seems here I forgot to remove some render details. So let's render this, shall we? To fully utilize this workflow, you need to understand these two sections of the workflow, but don't worry, I've got you covered. As you can see here, we've got amazing images. Most of them even have the correct amount of fingers. But there are exceptions, of course. By the way, if you need help with prompting or your general workflow, I have guides for this on Patreon. I have something for free members, but also exclusive content, so check out my free stuff, link in description. So time to talk about the shift node. It's connected to the checkpoint loader, so what does it do? The shift is for fine-tuning the sampling process. Let's assume we want to render 30 steps and we have chosen a high shift value. That would mean that the first sampling step get less computational effort while the sampling steps in the middle get the maximum effort and the last sampling steps get less again. It's a bell curve, practically. A low shift value on the other hand distributes it evenly. I tested values from 1 to 50, so you don't have to. This is shift 1. While they don't look bad in particular, they have a lot of dark areas. Some parts seem even unfinished. It could be pure coincidence, but shift 2 seems to have a lot of trouble with anatomy again. So from my testing, I got the best results with shift values from 3 to 8. Here on shift 15, you can see it gets blurry and uneven. And it gets worse. Here's 20. They lose pretty much everything. This is 30 now, 40. And I stopped at 50 because it made no sense to go higher. It gets stranger when you try to upscale. This is shift 6 and I tried to upscale with a denoising of 0.3 and I got this weird face on her back. Moving on to the negative conditioning. The negative prompt box output has two connections. One goes in the zero conditioning out and the other one goes directly in the conditioning set time step range. This means that the negative prompt conditioning is only running for the first 10% of the image rendering. This upper box runs from 10% to 100, but this goes to the conditioning zero out first, so that means the conditioning gets removed after the first 10% of the rendering. Then it gets combined and fed into the case sampler. So naturally I check this out for you. I ran it from 0 to 50%, but the image differences are really subtle. There's this monster-like shape here on the background, but this could also be a coincidence again. I explained this to you as far as I understood it from the research paper, but I'm not an expert, so take my information with a grain of salt. Let me show you how to separate an existing prompt to the three text encoders. I let ChatGPT give me this prompt of a photo inside an old rustic potion shop that is filled with shelves and colorful bottles. Let's start by modifying the clip L encoder. I don't want a photo and I don't want ray tracing. I want an epic comic drawing. Instead of box art, I want DVD cover art. Also, let's take this down here and put the eerie atmosphere in the middle prompt box, which is our clip G encoder. Let's try it out. These are great for a first attempt. This here is really shady, really cool. This is nice. I mean, don't look at his hands, but this face says, hey, I've got a good deal for you. One of the hardest things to achieve in Stable Diffusion 3 is apparently generating people laying on grass. With this workflow, you can easily do it. Eggmanic on Civitai made it possible. Give his workflow a thumbs up for achieving the impossible. So, what's my opinion on Stable Diffusion 3? I think Stability AI could have communicated clearer what to expect from this medium model. I mean, what did they expect? That we don't realize it? Another problem is the unclear licensing, which is why creators are holding back on the creation of community fine-tunes. I think I like Stable Diffusion 3 for the most part. It won't replace SDXL and certainly not SD1.5, which has still the best toolchain in terms of ControlNet, for example. All in all, this model has potential and I will experiment with it a lot more in the future and keep you updated. While you are waiting for the community fine-tunes, I suggest you watch this video next to level up your art skills.